Bonjour! Aujourd'hui est Bastille Day, France's national day of celebration.
And we're celebrating.
Justine Schofield is tapping into her mum's Parisian roots to show us how to create the perfect French cheese board. And Justine joins us now, live from Bris Vegas.
Bonjour, mes amis! How are you?
We're good.
Bastille Day. Ça va bien. Et toi?
We're well prepared. I've got Grant Denny's gloves
bien,
on.
Merci.
You can tell I haven't worn a rubber for a while. Look at this.
Not too soon.
Do you know what?
Just brought it down.
Justine, it is Bastille Day. And you actually have some Parisian connections. Your mum is French.
I do. Yes, Françoise. She's probably watching right now with a glass of champagne and probably a cheese board just like this in front of her. So it's a very happy day in the Schofield family because we celebrate Bastille Day, 14th of July, and that always involves a lot of cheese and a lot of alcohol.
Sounds about right.
So how can we do a cheese board as good as yours?
Yes, well, I really wanted to show off some of my favourite cheeses at the moment, and I know a lot of you out there do know fromager dauphinois, which is the best. Luscious, gooey, creamy, oozy. It is the best cheese ever. And this is obviously the most famous one, le fromager, but I want to show you the first board here. I think the biggest thing when you're making a cheese board at home is just to keep it simple and make it all about the cheese. So this is a wash rind. You don't need 100 cheeses with it. You need
smell
one. Beautiful cheese. This is pungent. And you want simple things with it. So some French baguette, of course. And in France, we don't cut the baguette. We rip it.
Okay.
With apples and some quince. You guys cooking along, are you?
Or yes, we are. That's what we're trying to do.
Some walnuts.
Any other hacks? I mean, you break the bread.
What else? Maybe just slice.
Break the bread. And with your pungent cheese, like Le Compagnie, you want to serve it with, like, a wheat beer. It works really, really well. Because I do want to show you how to pair wines with cheeses. Yeah, a beer. A wheat beer works really nice because it cuts through the richness of the beautiful punginess of Le Compagnie. I want to take you over here because I know a lot of people don't like blue cheeses, but Fromager Dauphinois Bleu is to die for because it is still quite creamy and buttery, and you just got that slight sweetness from the blue in there. So if you're a beginner with blue, then this is your one. I serve it with honeycomb, pears, and I've even made my own lavoche. You know, lavoche is so expensive when you go to the shops, but making it yourself is cheap and it always tastes better. And I like to pair it with a buttery Chardonnay, if you like.
Okay.
And then it comes to the big one, and this is where I get really excited. This is one that Mum introduced me to, and we always bring it out on our table on Bastille Day, le fromager. It's the double cream. I want to show you. This is the joy of Bastille Day, having a whole wheel of cheese. And, you know, you don't cut a small bit.
No,
it's generous. In France, we are generous. We want about half of this wheel. I want to show you how gorgeous it is.
Oh my God. Also, you
want to bring your cheeses out of the fridge. At least an hour before serving it, because you're really going to get the flavour of this gooey, gorgeous, ripe cheese. I'm going to pop that there, a slab of cheese. It's not just a Bastille Day.
Slabbing away yesterday.
Let's keep celebrating.
How do we decorate it? That is
actually really good with champagne.
Is it breads on the outside? How do we decorate the platter? I've never really seemed to assemble it properly. Is it bread on the outside? How do we do that?
Yeah. Great question. I find, you know, sometimes when people are designing their cheese boards, they put everything from strawberries to salami to cabanossi to Devon. Stay away from that and keep it really simple. I can't recommend that more. And if you've got seasonal fruits like pears and apples, put it on there. I've got gorgeous prunes in syrup, quince paste.
Good job,
muscatels are great.
Prunes in syrup.
If you keep it simple like this and really showcase the cheese, then I find it's much more appealing to the eye. And like I said, because we're heroing this, bring the cheese out of the fridge early and match it with the right a drink. So, you know, French champagne goes so nicely with it because the bubbles cut through the richness.
Yes, that's exactly why I drink French champagne, as well as to cut through the richness of it all.
Important to cut through the richness, very important.
Well, this is a very fancy looking
cheese
board.
Very important, which means you can have more fromage.
That's it. Plus de fromage.
This is gorgeous. Thank you so much. You can catch Justine on Everyday Gourmet. Weekdays, 4 p.m. at 10. Happy Bastille Day, Justine.
You're a star.
Au revoir.
Happy Bastille Day there. Au revoir.
Au revoir.